Martin Kilcoyne back with you on Sunday Sports Extra. Had a chance to talk to Dr. Richard Chaifetz this week. The huge Billiken basketball fan. His name is on the arena after all. A SLU alum, but also the owner, the founder of ComPsych, which is real busy these days with what's going on around our globe. We catch up with Dr. Chaifetz. First topic, the Billiken basketball team that was rolling right at the end of this season.
I was hoping to see them, you know, obviously win the Atlantic 10 and then get into the tournament. It was very disappointing, but, you know, completely understandable. You can't jeopardize people's health by going and to a basketball game in the middle of a virus pandemic.
What's your level of excitement? Really, the state of the program right now. We got local kids. You've got people that have NBA potential. I know you've been a long-time backer of the program. What's your take as of the current state?
I'm incredibly excited. I mean, this might be, this coming year, the best team we've ever put on the floor. Obviously, I was a big Rick Majerus fan. We had a great team there, and then Cruz took it further when Rick unfortunately passed away. But the talent on this team is unprecedented for SLU, and it doesn't even count the new recruits that we'll be getting. So I'm incredibly excited.
Tell me about your ComPsych world, what you guys are doing in the middle of this pandemic, and how busy you are.
ComPsych is the world's largest provider of employee assistance programs. So we cover about 100 million people in 120 countries. So we get a good view of really what's going on throughout the world. And I fortunately get to talk to a number of senators and congressmen on a regular basis because we do the federal government and various components to provide services for them as well. Obviously, this is unprecedented times. We've never shut the U.S. economy down for a period of time like this. So the impact on people's lives is dramatic. Emotional impact, financial impact, the ability to live your life the normal way you're used to living in a free society is unprecedented for us not to be able to do. But I think part of the problem for people, unfortunately, is that there's no predictability. We don't have a clear sense of when this is going to end. And as human beings, we like to control our environment, control our destiny, and have some degree of certainty about what's going to happen to us. And with this pandemic, we just don't know that.
Your company is in demand right now as we talk about all these services that are needed. Now, how do you manage it? Because you also have to worry about the health and well-being of your people.
100%. And that comes first. Obviously, without our people, we're a service business. Without our people, we're nothing. And our people make our business. So we had a disaster recovery plan, a business continuity plan for years in anticipation of not necessarily a pandemic, but any kind of closing of our offices, our corporate office in Chicago, or our offices around the world. About 3.5 weeks ago, we moved virtually almost everyone home. We have about 97% of our employees worldwide working from home. So all offices are closed, people are at home, and it's working generally pretty well. But we got to work with them too. They are under tremendous stress. I mean, they're seeing and hearing from people on a regular basis that are going through, you know, the crisis of their lives, so to speak. And we do that through video conferencing. We do that through phone counseling. We do it through webinars. And we use technology, state-of-the-art technology, to interface with our patients, with our clients, and the rest of our customers. And our customer base is broad. It's small companies, large companies, private companies, public companies, the federal government, states, municipalities, broad base. We have about 58,000 customers. So it's we see everything from all sizes, all shapes, all types.
Is there a healing message? Because it's so unprecedented. I'm not sure that any of us really know what the answer is. But people that are, I don't know if there's a person on the planet that isn't stressed to a certain degree. Is there an overall overriding message from the professionals?
You got somebody who is a doctor or a medical professional. They're going to serve and help a COVID-19 patient. And they themselves then also become the counselors in many respects. The mental health therapist, because the people's families are not there. They're not allowed into the hospital. And then they're also worried about their own health. This is a highly contagious virus. No one knows exactly still how it transmits. I mean, we have a lot of hypotheses, you know, through the air, through surface, et cetera, but we learn every day.